Okay, so welcome to Vision Board Community Podcast for a long time team. So today I just want to invite Vishnu. So Vishnu will give you more insight regarding like an Azure data engineering journey and what are the things he learned. So some kind of insightful thoughts or words will help you this community. That's why I invited Vishnu to this podcast. Vishnu, welcome to this podcast.
Hello, Devi.
Yeah, good evening. Am I audible?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay, great. So Vishnu, welcome to the podcast. So maybe you can give some kind of introduction about yourself and how the journey looks like. Now you get an offer letter and you crack the company. So how the journey looks like? Can you give some insight to the community members?
Yeah, sure, Devi. So I'm working at TCS currently. So I started my journey 1 year ago with you. Hope you remember December, right?
Definitely. I know. Because Vishnu was the first, we started like a consistency challenge. So consistency challenge onwards, Vishnu, me, like a, we are like a very close relationship and we are calling together, and consistency is one important thing. You also, Vishnu also know that one. So that was the journey we together started. Yes, Vishnu?
Yeah, I still remember the date, December 9th.
Exactly.
Yeah. So, first of all, I started completing Azure certifications because I'm not sure where to start. And you insisted me to do that certifications. So, I started doing that. And in this process, I came to know, I mean, I'm familiar with the Azure stuff, Azure services. So, Azure Logic Apps and Azure Blob, ADL. So, all these things I came familiar only while doing the certifications. So, these were the basics, right? I mean, later on, I started like, you know, coding in Python. So, we have implemented some sessions. By providing some tasks in the evenings.
Exactly.
Yeah, and later on, regarding the Excel sheet, which you have tracked SQL and Python problems, everything. I still follow the things, maybe. I mean, while preparing the interviews, you know, as a kind of revision.
Exactly, because a beginner, completely Python is like a completely new. So we need some kind of extra time, right? Learning the things and implementing those things. So that's why that Excel sheet will help us to like a following the career way.
Even I haven't coded every time. I mean, I just very documentation all those things.
Okay.
So just for a quick revision, because every interview we may not get a chance to revise all the things, right?
Exactly.
So if we look on to the logic, so we can implement it. At least if we cannot implement, we can express it, right? The logic,
yes,
in the interview. So this was the thing which I'm doing every coding round. Even the PySpark thing which you have provided, the questions, you made us practice, right? In the morning sessions, 8 a.m.
Actually, PySpark, I think these days also very booming kind of thing. So Vishnu was continuous. Vishnu was consistently practicing those things. So that is the one of the reason, right? Vishnu, you can able to crack more than 100% hike in the current companies and all. So one year it's like a period to learning more thing, more on the database exposure. That is really good. So that is Then how the interviews looks like, Vishnu, like and when you're attending the interviews, right? Because when I was attending like a 2 years back or something, it was completely different. But how you looks like currently, like and how the interview perspective, then what is the requirement mainly from the company side?
I started giving interviews in December 2023. I mean, not 20 December, in the November 2023.
Okay.
So last year, November, I have given 11 interviews. There I came to know, I mean, I have learned how to prepare myself for the interviews and the questions. A few questions from the Spark were repeatedly asking in the L1 interviews. Mostly in the L1 interviews were tough, actually, nowadays. The candidates get filtered in the L1 round, but when coming to L2 round and L3 round, majorly they are asking the real-time scenarios, which are repeatedly asking, like I can say Spark optimization techniques and debugging Spark logs. So the same questions, I mean, L2 round and L3 round very easy, but L1 round is much difficult nowadays.
Okay. L1 round is much, because filtering is very high, right, these days?
Yeah.
Okay. And one more thing I just want to ask, like, because I suggested, like, people to learn and acquire certification. The certification, do you believe these certifications are really impacting attending, like, an interviews?
Yeah, definitely. Maybe if the recruiters are reaching out to me, they are looking at my LinkedIn profile actually, and the certifications which I have on achievements. So I realized it when the HR calls and asking me regarding the achievements as a proof of concept. So I said that I have done these certifications and I am holding it, and the achievements which I made. At TCS, so I'm holding these things as a proof of concept of my achievements and the certifications, and they are getting impressed and they are moving for further process. And also, even in the L3 round or the HR round, they are preferring the certifications, and also they have put me the question, are you willing to do database professional certification? Even they have insisted. I said yes, I'm in a plan in doing it.
Okay. That is also really they want, right?
Yeah.
Okay. That's why, because when the profile need to be shortlisted, they need to know about this candidate is potential one, and they have some kind of specific coding skills also in PySpark or Python SQL. That's why they are given that kind of filtration also.
Not only one time, Devi. I have put three times about the Databricks professional certificate in the L2 rounds.
Okay. Oh, that's also the part of journey, right?
Yeah. And coming to interviews, Devi, earlier, you know, I've faced a lot of struggles. Like, if I started to prepare, you know, it will not get complete before the interview. Something, you know, I may be going to miss before the interview, maybe ADF part or ADB part, or when coming to the coding part, at least two parts will be in pending to revise. So after January, what I did is I'm just, you know, going to the position role. If it is only Azure Databricks role, so I used to concentrate only on the Azure Databricks role much more. And coming to ADF part, I already have knowledge, right? So if they put any questions, I can manage. So this was the thing which I'm doing right now.
Okay. That is really good, because when the some of the sessions also, Vishnu is mentioned, like a different scenarios, right? It will be like a completely new kind of scenario they will be asking these days. Like, for example, you have a 100 table, how you be migrate, and these kind of like a real time question, they will be noticing how you solve this one, right? These kind of question, normally we are getting, for example, 5 plus of experience people, right, Vishnu?
Yeah.
Okay. Then what do you think, like what is the core part? If someone is attending to interview, what is the core part people need to be focused? What are the skill set you suggesting to people, Vishnu?
Right now, Azure Databricks and PySpark, they are more, you know, concentrating and looking forward.
Exactly.
So I prefer only Azure Databricks and PySpark.
Okay. But, packages also, right? Package also very high for these roles.
But there are a few people are asking Azure Data Factory ingestion, because while we start expressing the project which we are currently working, so they are targeting the ingestion layer, especially. So at the moment, we need to be answerable for those things.
Okay. Got it.
When we are starting the interviews, we may not be able to revise all the things, but going forward, we will be targeting the roles. Actually, we should be targeting the only roles. So based upon the roles and the JD, we need to prepare and we need to revise it.
Oh, that is a really good suggestion for community member also. Team, if you're getting these kind of things, you You can focus on the role specific for prepare for the interview. Otherwise, you will get a lot of questions from different scenarios.
Even I have asked the HR for multiple times. So how the interview is going to be? Is it any particular to Azure Databricks or Azure Data Factory? So that, you know, we can get more information. So exactly. What interviewer is expecting from us?
Then it will be, we can prepare easily, right? That is a nice idea. Okay.
I have done these things, David.
Really great, Vishnu. That is a really good tip to the community itself. And for example, Vishnu, if you ask someone like for helping mentality, they will be asking, Vishnu, how you prepared for the interview? Okay. So for example, if you ask like an, how you prepared? So what are the suggestions you will be given from your side to them?
My preparation in the sense, it's a long time, baby. First, you know, I have targeted, I mean, I have first prepared the project explanation, which I should explain it. So after explaining the things, you know, I didn't expect like, you know, it is not up to much. I have prepared it, you know, over the time. Like, so once I prepared it, I tend to two or three interviews. So if they put questions again to me on the same project layer, so I need to, you know, include, the Azure gaps. Actually, my data source systems is earlier on-premise SQL Server and attachments. So when I attended three interviews in November, so they put me few questions like the attachments you are getting, right? So how you will upload them into ADLS automatically? So at the moment, I don't know, like we can use the Azure Logic Apps. So later on, I learned that and Azure Logic Apps, by using Azure Logic Apps, we can, there will be some pre-configured metrics and we need to choose pre-configured metrics and based upon that, we need to push the data into ADLS. So these things I learned over the time. So when they put questions to us, you know, it is a chance of learning. And also, after attending few interviews, I came to know that the interviewers were getting dissatisfied with only two data source systems. So later on, I added SAP and REST API. A few of them I have added, and I got the full knowledge about the establishment of the connections, and then only I added it.
Okay.
So this is the project explanation, maybe. It needs to be improved every interview.
So when you're attending the interviews only, you can get an understand, right? So otherwise, we cannot understand anything. So that's a good tip also. Team, actually, if you're looking for a change also, what you need to do, first you need to be upskill yourself. Upskill and learn or attend the interview, then you will get some more insight. Then again, you can attend the interview, you will get. So same way, meantime, you need to be, you can learn new item, for example, generative AI, database kind of thing. So these kind of thing also will enhance your profile. That is the one suggestion. In the IT industry, when you're staying, definitely you are a continuous learner. That is the point. So don't need to give up. So that is the thing I'm just telling about Vishnu also. Vishnu didn't give up any time. So always he learned a lot of things, implement and added in the profile, again attend the interview, then implement. So now the Vishnu has a good caliber to handle any kind of situation. So that is the one we need to be expecting from others also. Right, Vishnu?
Yeah, Devi. We can take break, but we should not give up.
Yes. So we can take a break also sometime due to personal reasons and all. Break definitely we need, but we don't need to give up. So we need to continuously practice, learn the skill, because IT industry Azure also, the 2022 prompt engineering is very booming right now. Gen AI is booming. So what we need to do, whatever the time we are getting, we upskill, implement it, add in our profile, then apply for a job. If you really want to looking for a job, apply for it. Definitely luck will be happen at the point of time. Okay. So that is the thing. Anyway, thanks Vishnu. Thank you so much for sharing this beautiful insight to the community itself. And any kind of messages you want to share with the community finally?
I can say, Devi, so what level you are at the moment, just go with the flow, and it can be improved over the time. I mean, we should improve ourselves, you know, by observing the things, what questions the interviewers are going to put us, and what we need to correct ourselves. This is the thing which I have done.
Really great, Vishnu. So definitely we need a one more podcast after you join the companies and all. So I think that will be giving more. That time you will be attending a lot of interviews and you will get more insight you can provide to the community itself. You are in new roles after 6 months or 1 year, new roles. And so I'm expecting one more podcast. Anyway, thank you so much, Vishnu, for your time, for doing this
one.
Sharing your great transition. Grateful to you for sharing this one. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, Lee. Thank you.